Hey, how you doing? Zach Brown, Chicken Fried. So you already know, probably, is G, D, and C, the chords you want to use. Okay, first, that introduction. Okay, let me show you that. You focus pretty much on the last four strings of each of those chords. For example, the G, I'm just going to play this much of that G. Thumb stays on the four string for this one. Does help finger picking. Let's see, D chord's already a four chord, but you're actually going to be using the fourth, third, and second strings of that. The C chord, again, fourth, third, and second strings, so you're just using pieces of these chords. It's like you do a lick and you land on the chord. For example, this first part, you have an A and a C under your second and first fingers right here. See that? Slide up two frets to B and D. Okay? See that? Now that's a pull off from the C. Open G, open D, open G, open B, and a G up top. Part. And that. Do that so you landed on this much of a D, and then you got this part. There's that part. Okay, and then you do your walk up. Put my eye finger on the G string. And with my thumb, I do a G an octave below. G, A, B, C, D. Okay? Let me do that slow. Let's do some of the song, then I'll talk some more about it. You know I like my chicken fried, cold beer on a Friday night, a pair of jeans a bit just right, and the radio. Okay, that's the chorus chords. Now remember, the chorus doesn't begin on beat one of the measure, it begins on beat two. So in other words, you know I like my chicken fried. Begins on fried, not on chicken. You'd think it would be, you know I like my chicken fried. Because that is the downbeat of that measure. But one of the neat little things that they throw in there to make it really, really interesting is they begin it on beat two, which is more unexpected. So you know I like my chicken fried. Like that, okay? One of the things that really drives the chorus is that bass line that throws in there. So you know I like my chicken fried. Something like that. Okay? I tried to incorporate some of that into the chords because I really, really love the way it just drives you right along there. So the first few notes of that bass lick happen to coincide with the bottom four strings of my G chord. So what I do is when I begin the G chord on beat two, I play the whole chord. So one, two, three, four, one. See that? One, three, four, one. And I can still walk up. See, I'm still on a G chord, so I'm doing the B of this. I can do an upstroke into those open strings of the G chord. Go right into my D right there. So that's one, two, three, four, one, two. Hang on. All right. Let's see. The verse goes into a halftime feel. Remember, you don't have to play the whole chord all the time. Try playing just pieces of chords, and it gets you far. Well, I was raised up beneath the shade of a Georgia pine. That's home, you know. Sweet tea, pecan pie, homemade wine with peaches. My house is not much to talk about, but it's filled with love that's grown in the southern ground. And a little bit of chicken fried. Peace of mind, and this I've come to know. So if you agree, have a drink with me, raise your glasses for a toast to a little bit of chicken pie. Thanks a lot for watching. Take care, man.
Bye.